Hi, this is Rich. How you doing? So, if this what was going on in the world right now were actually a Marvel comic universe or a Doctor Who universe, we have time travel and we have super beings and super villains and stuff like that. If that were overlaid on what's really going on here, or the other way around. Oh, did you see that one, WandaVision? That's Wanda with the superpowers, and she created her own little world, her own reality. Superpowers, right? So I'm thinking about all this stuff and how there's soft disclosure in Hollywood movies and all this, so we can share what's going on. They, the bad guys, can share what's going on and the dystopian societies that they would like to see. They can share that stuff in videos and movies. So when we focus on it, think about it, the idea is, hey, maybe we'll manifest it. We'll manifest this stuff. When Thanos makes half the population of Earth disappear. Yeah. So, oh, and then when the population does return, they're going to get, it's they're preaching in the movie. In the various movies of the Marvel Comic Universe, they're pushing one world, one people government, right? So I'm looking at all this stuff and what the Tibetans are saying about everything, and I go, okay, if I were going to write a movie based on a possible real reality, and I wanted to know thy enemy or take it from the enemy's perspective or the bad guy's perspective, I started coming up with the scenario, and I want to run it by you real quick. It can get really in detail because it's like writing a movie script, right, or a screenplay or a treaty or something on the subject. But if I were somewhat in control of the reptilian, regressive reptilian, not all reptilians are bad, but if the regressive reptilian contingency or empire was going through the universe or the galaxy looking to control and dominate worlds, this is what these regressives do, okay? So this could be a Marvel comic movie, right? Or a Doctor Who series. The evil ones that want to control and dominate all the worlds and life forms, they would love to get Earth and the solar system and all of this. So they come with their armadas and their battle wagons and their Death Stars, and there's a big war in our solar system. Good guys versus bad guys. The bad guys are the reptilians, and others, minions or allies of the reptilians to conquer the sector of the galaxy. Okay, so there they are. But the good guys are like 500,000 planets of civilized progressive races of all kinds. Okay, now they see the threat. War is going on in what is commonly called 5D, but it's just the physical universe without the mind warp that we experience here on Earth with the energy field around us that keeps us dumbed down, ignorant, and unperceptive, and thinking and feeling all negative and shit. Okay. So we call this 3D Earth, or you could say that the Galactic Federation refers to themselves as 5D, while we are 3D. It's just a distinction between free of energy, of a mind control energy field, kind of like Wi-Fi and G5 and electromagnetic field radiation pollution, except on fucking steroids. It's kind of like that all of Earth. So you get on Earth, it's very toxic in this kind of way, and we're dumbed down and limited, and we lose our psychic abilities and our ability our telepathic abilities and our knowing and our memories, all this stuff is wiped out or blocked when we come in to here. Anyway, the 500,000 progressive races, and we've got all kinds. There's human-looking things and all others, and I have no idea. We know there's cat people and dog-looking people and all kinds. Okay. They want to protect themselves from the regressive fucking consume the universe machine. So they get together as a federation of planets, the United Federation of Planets, or the Galactic Federation. So each of these planets and systems have to have a representative, and this would be like what we would consider a politician or a diplomat, and they're calling the shots in these councils. With 500,000 planets and all these sectors and these vast distances, our galaxy is going to be, you know, blocked into sectors and subsectors and all this, and then councils and sub-councils and all like this. And like people in New Jersey, some little small town in New Jersey, they're going to be controlled by a certain group of people that call the shots and enforce the laws and even make local laws and regulations, right? So it's small government for small places that are governed by the larger state government, which is governed by the national government and the laws and stuff. So there's a step down. So here we are, us here on Earth, we are being the Galactic Federation. It's a council or a group of controllers, we'll just call them controllers, and they control the business, what can happen in this sector, like in the solar system and on Earth and stuff like that. But they're not the Galactic Federation, which is too huge. It's like local city council for some small town is not the United States government, right? Okay. So anyway, the Galactic Federation puts together their army, their military, their space navy, and we have massive military might. And before Earth got turned to shit, there was war going on in our galaxy. Reptilians and the regressives against those that want to be safe and free and progressive, right? So big battle ensues many years ago. And we've heard about the war in heaven and all the space battleship, probably different places. Robert Morning Sky has a real good rendition of it, and there are others, but that's the one I'm most familiar with. It's pretty good. It talks about the reptilians and the Anunnaki and all this stuff. Anyway, in this space battle, the latest story I heard, and I heard it from Cosmic Agency, the Tibetan Pleiadian ETs, which I highly recommend if you're just getting interested in what's going on off planet and on planet and in our galaxy. As far as I'm concerned, they're the real deal, and they're good-hearted human beings, incredibly knowledgeable, experienced, and really doing the best they can to help us here. Okay, so big space battle. This planet Tiamat gets blown up, and shit's all over the place. And the reptilians have a base on Earth. They've already somehow captured Earth long, long ago, right? It was a Lyran outpost or a colonized planet, Lyran human. But they got overwhelmed by the reptilians, So now the reptilians actually have a military base on Earth of long ago. Now, in this big space battle, now wouldn't this make a great Marvel Comics or a Doctor Who or a Hollywood movie sort of thing? But they won't tell, they won't share this stuff. I choked just thinking about it. Anyway, so the good guys, the Galactic Federation, good guys of all kinds of races, and even there are reptilian good races of reptilians and all this. They see an opportunity to capture the military headquarters, or you know, frontline military post of the reptilians in this big battle. They see an opportunity to catch the reptilians, and they take it. Unfortunately, it was like a, it wasn't, well, it wasn't a Death Star sort of thing like in Star Wars, but from the moon they were able to generate an energy field over the entire Earth. And it's like having some monkeys in a cage and generating a electromagnetic field around them that is so weird and overwhelming that the monkeys can't think clearly, and they get easily paranoid, and their vision is lower, and all their senses are lessened, and their ability to perceive the world around them is extremely limited. They're dumbed down, right? Because of an electromagnetic field or some kind of radiation, energy radiation, right? So basically, this is the story of what happened for real on Earth. So this energy goes around in our entire planet, but it's to catch the reptilians, to dumb them down, knock them, slow them down, and it worked. So it imprisoned the reptilians. Pretty good, huh? The good guys, Galactic War, and there's humans involved, and Pleiadians involved, and Alcyons, and Andromedans, and all these, the good guys of the Galactic Federation, the United Federation of Planets, is here to save the day. So they capture the entire planet that's controlled by the reptilians, and they're controlling and dominating the humans, the human Lyrans on planet Earth, long, long ago. Well, spoiler alert, they're still doing it. But here's what happened. As the, so the reptilians are captured. Well, the humans on the planet are the effect of the same thing. So the humans on the planet were also dumbed down, their perceptions were limited, and they're still messed up. But guess what? The reptilians are still in control. But from the galactic perspective, and the Galactic Federation perspective, and the big giant war in heaven sort of thing, they've contained the reptilians on Earth. So they're on Earth, prison planet for reptilians. Unfortunately, we're humans are here, right? So fast forward many thousands of years, and the reptilians, now this is my theory, okay? This is my theory, and this is the story I could write. We want to imagine new stories about reality, because your reality is nothing more than your story. If you look around what's going on in the world right now, if you look at certain things, you're going to have one story about what's going on, and there's more likelihood of your story manifesting in your physical experience than not. If you're not thinking or imagining something, it's not going to manifest. On some level, you have to think about it, focus on it, and manifest it. Generally speaking, right? Now that gets real complex and all that shit about how reality is manifest. And I didn't know they were going to, you know, invade us. Well, how did I manifest that, right? It gets complex, But generally speaking, okay. So we need to come up with some new stories, some new ideas, imagine new positive things, or we have to imagine a story that makes sense to us in such a way that we come out of it empowered instead of disempowered or limited. Now, while, see, the dark side, the reptilians and those in control of planet Earth right now know how this works. So they're doing everything they can to create fear, worry, concern, and they're using lies and deception to do so. But if they can get the masses to think and believe that, that's what is the reality for the planet. And then when the masses agree to a lie, like the dark side will create a problem. It's called problem reaction solution as a mass population control mechanism. Those in power will create a lie. It's a lie, but they'll manufacture a problem that isn't really a problem, except for the fact that they've created it as a problem. And then the population will react emotionally, and then they are susceptible to restrictions and new rules, new regulations, and new behavior patterns, and more control by those in power. And those in power have the excuse that this is for your own good, we're going to do this, we're going to do that, and we're going to do the other thing. And the population is supposed to be afraid, and they'll give up their rights and their freedoms and go okay and agree to things. So that's what's happened now, see. You know what I'm talking about too, right? But they do that a lot. They've used this problem, reaction, solution, mass control mechanism frequently. Okay. Because another thing they have to get, the dark side has to get our agreement that it's okay to do something or agree that something is what it is. So there can be a radiation situation that isn't really a radiation situation. Let's say there was some accident and it wasn't really a radiation accident, a nuclear thing. but they could say it is and then offer everybody a radiation pill, and this will protect you from the radiation fallout. And what if the pill isn't what it's said to be? We're just told it's one thing when it's something else, but we've agreed to take the pill. When we agree to take the pill, now we're the effect of what the pill is going to do to the body, right? So that would be a scenario. And we could use this in our Doctor Who or our Marvel Comics story that I'm fleshing out here for you. Okay. Now, okay, so there's this big war. The reptilians are captured. The reptilians that captured the Lyrians, they are now captured, but they can still mess with the Lyrians. Lyrians. So this goes on for thousands of years. And so as far as we're concerned on Earth, we're still the effect of the control and domination tactics of the reptilian controllers on Earth. And the way they do it is they'll get their own bloodlines. They'll mix human with reptilian in just different kinds of ways. They will interact with the human race, and they will have their own peeps in positions of power. And these reptilians are advanced ET races, right? They're just imprisoned on planet Earth. That's okay. They don't care. They've got their buddies off planet. They're still reptilians. I mean, the reptilians are still around. They're like not fighting right now so much, as I understand it. They're not fighting in our sector of the galaxy. The Galactic Federation has a very strong military, and there's sort of, you know, maybe there's a skirmish here and there, I don't know the details, but there's not so much fighting out in 5D. Galactic Federation has everything under control, right? Yeah, this is a movie. This is, plays like a fucking movie, man, a science fiction fucking story. Because in fact, my perspective, man, others might agree with me on this. The reptilians never gave the fuck up. Those off planet, they're intelligent. They have, they're a passion and purpose to control and dominate the fucking galaxy, including the Galactic Federation and the Federation of Planets. What, they just gave up and walked away? I don't think so. I believe they got smarter. Okay. Using might and force did not work. And they've got their buds on planet Earth. Okay. they want to take care of their allies or their buddies on planet Earth, the reptilians controlling the planet. But now they've apparently left our sector, or left our that space and place in our galaxy that is protected by the Galactic Federation. So that's the story, the apparent theme. Here's what I think, Captain. I think those fucking clever reptilians have been scheming and planning all this time, and they're using the same lies and deception, trickery, deceit, intrigue, moles and spies, and plant people here and shape their shapeshifters, and then they're blackmail and coercion and all this evil shit, right? It's like a 60s spy movie sort of thing with agents, double agents and triple agents and all this stuff. Anyway, what I think happened? The reptilians somehow have cleverly infiltrated the councils, the Galactic Federation councils that control matters, that call the shots. Just like, it's like cleaning up the swamp in America, right? We got the shadow government. It's government. Their government agencies are corrupt. Damn. What a surprise that it would be like that in the Galactic Federation government. Oh, no, not there. Oh, fucking please. Why wouldn't there be? Common sense says these reptilians out there in the fucking galaxy, in the Orion or wherever the fuck they are, what, they just rolled over and gave up and left? I don't fucking think so. They're in their secret fucking places going, how do we not just control and dominate this, but this planet and that planet? Is there a way to get control and domination of the entire Galactic Federation? I don't think they've done that yet, but I think that would be the fucking plan. That'd be my plan, your plan. You don't just want more planet. You want the whole fucking shebang. So, how do we do that? They haven't asked how to, well, it's real easy. The same thing they've been doing our big guys, and they had military, I would say they had military intelligence and strategists, real clever guys on how to do things. On the planet, if Earth was a military outpost or a military base for the reptilians during the big war, you see. Now they're captured. So these beings that are captured, are they still around? So anyway, my story is that, yeah, they're still around, or the replacements are still around. And the reptilian intelligence have worked it out to get their people in Galactic Federation positions of power. Probably not just our sector around the solar system, like on Saturn and Jupiter and stuff, but in other places too. But of course they would work that. So I say they did it. So they've got some of their people in positions of power that are calling the shots about what goes on Earth. That's my story. And this would make a great Doctor Who fucking thing. Or a Netflix miniseries, right? Okay, so let's just say it's a Netflix miniseries. And, okay, so they got their guys in place. But the guys, that we'll call them Federation diplomats or Federation controllers, local controllers, that would be the ones that say, the Pleiadians, nobody interferes with what's going on Earth. We can't step in. We draw the line here. Nobody in, nobody out. Shit like that. They're controlling what can come and go on planet Earth. Information and technology, okay? And people and ships and all that stuff. So they get to call the shots. So we're calling them the controllers, the local Galactic Federation controllers of the solar system and Earth. Okay. Well, there's some double agents in there. I mean, there's some spies in there. They're not what they're actually working for the reptilians, the regressives, but they're politicians, and they're pretending to be the good guys. Just like you can have satanic fucking politicians on camera, they're talking to the audience, the masses, and they're sounding like the good guys. They're saying it's for your own good, and they're coming up with clever stories, and they get probably somebody writing their speech and shit like that, but they're telling the masses something. And it's all about mass psychology and propaganda and control of the masses, social engineering. That's high-tech stuff. Very high IQ psychologist types have been hired to work out the details of how do you do mass social engineering, mind control of the masses. What do we got to do? So that's what's been going on planet Earth. But I say that same techniques are being used in the Galactic Federation. So that these diplomats or controllers or representatives that call the shots on planet Earth and the solar system are doing the same fucking things corrupt politicians do here. They're saying one thing and they're talking to the masses. They're talking, the news is going out to 500,000 planets. You know, a lot of people on those planets, they don't know about Earth, they don't give a shit, but some do. And the ones more local and close to here, the Procyons, the Alcyons, the Andromedans, Pleiadians, different Sirens, Lyrans, whatever. They do hear what the Galactic Federation diplomats are puking out, and they're pretty smart, and they're thinking outside the box. There's a lot of what you would call metaphysical phenomena or psychic perception stuff that they have, and they don't let us forget that. The Earth people, they're not really, they're all the free will of the people on Earth doesn't count because they have another aspect of themselves that are in 5D. And their free will matters. Political bullshit, politician babble. That's what I say. And in fact, they're corrupt. And in fact, step back a little bit further. This is a strategy from the reptilians, the dark side, not just wanting to take over Earth, but there's an infiltration scheme going to infiltrate the Galactic Federation, various councils in various places. Long term, thousands upon thousands and thousands of years, they're setting this stuff up because they would like to dominate and control every planet in the Galactic Federation. They didn't give that fucking dream up, did they? You think? Maybe they stopped using might. It's not using force anymore. Who's got the biggest battleships and the biggest powerful weapons? More a psychological operation, but not just on Earth, but Galactic Federation-wise. So, I'm thinking that's what happened. And what else? So, how many 45-minute episodes do we got going here to tell this story? So yeah, to save things, this gets into the, like Matrix sort of phenomena too. The people off this planet, they understand how reality is created. And massive groups of people get together and they believe the same sort of things. They agree on the same thing. They agree on the environment. And it's like a massive daydream, consciously created dreamscape. Like if I could imagine a world, and there are people that can really do this, right? Today, there are many people who can visualize an alternate world. The Secret Life of Walter Mitty is a classic story, movie, book about all of this. But you see stories like this all the time. The most recent one is WandaVision in the Marvel comic universe. She's created her reality. She did a mind control thing on the local population, though, so hers... She does a little bit differently, but there's a lot of that mind control stuff going on. And anyway, the people in the environment, if you can imagine a dreamscape, daydream, and you can imagine other people talking to you, well, other beings can come into your dreamscape consciously agreeing to the environment that you've imagined. And they will see it exactly the way you imagine it. It's like two people in telepathic communication, psychic communication. They visualize an animal, and it's a giraffe. And the other guy goes, yeah, it's a giraffe. And they see the same giraffe. Okay, so we are creating the same phenomena. When one being imagines something, others can agree to it, and this becomes manifest. And this is two psychic people getting together and creating a little dream world that they can play in, a sandbox sort of thing. Well, this is how all realities are created, okay? And these advanced races off-planet, they know this. And so the physical universe off-planet Earth is a big sandbox. And every being in there who has incarnated into the physical universe experience off of planet Earth, not here, out there. A lot of them will know this, but there'll be some that probably don't. But it's not a secret. You don't have to work your whole life to figure out that one. It's a known. Okay, and they have advanced technology off planet Earth that can manifest it. Interacts with the mind and thought. Supercomputers that can interact with mind and the same wavelength and all this stuff. And so it blends. And so you can use technology to cause a person to imagine and see a scenario. And it looks like it's like virtual reality, but touchy-feely. And it's technology that puts a person in this environment. But not just one person, hundreds, thousands. So there's a lot of weird, deep, powerful, weird technology like that going on right now out there in the physical universe. So, those guys out there that would like to capture the superheroes. This is where in the Marvel universe or Doctor Who, this is where the superheroes come in. Superheroes have psychic abilities and powerful abilities like Doctor Strange, the warlock, the magician, the wizard, whatever you want to call them. And there's so many science fiction movies now with witches and warlocks and wizards and all this magical stuff. Well, yeah. So those beings actually exist in this physical universe off of this planet. Yeah. Now, those beings can move in and out of the physical universe. So let's say you've got some reptilians way over here in the Orion Belt somewhere, and you've got some loving, decent beings on some benevolent planet. And these beings on this loving, benevolent planet are very spiritually evolved, and they can do this sort of thing. They can move in and out of the physical universe. They can manifest stuff. They can walk through the walls. And I've actually talked to one myself. I've communicated with one of these beings that can do this. Yasky Swarup. Yeah. So anyway, these beings exist. There's not just one or two. There are many, many, many. Right? Now there's other super beings with superpowers that come in different ways. But in my story, these beings are from outside of the physical universe. It's not the astral plane. It's other belief system territories. It's other reality systems, other universes. It's a multiverse out there. Okay? So these powerful beings from other realms choose to play in the sandbox we call the physical universe. And as they're playing in this physical universe experience, they agree to the rules of the game. It's like going into a computer game. Let's say you have the cheat codes and you can walk through the walls and you can fly, but you don't type in God mode or unlimited ammo. You agreed to play the game and you'll play the game. Okay, so now you're in the game. And so these super beings come into the game and they may or may not have agreed to lose their superpowers or not use their superpowers or forget that they have their superpowers. So let's look at the ones that know they have their superpowers and their abilities. They know they can walk through the wall. They know they can levitate stuff. And they know how reality is created. Okay? So you're playing around the physical universe experience, and we get involved, we get emotionally engaged in life, which is nothing more or less than a game in a sandbox or a virtual reality or a matrix reality or a created reality based upon what we think, feel, believe, focus on, agree on, and thus manifest with our own thoughts. But millions or billions of people focus on the same stuff, agree on the same things, and tune into the vibration of the same planet, so everybody sees the same planet. You go to the planet, this guy goes to the planet, the other guy goes to the planet, everybody goes to the planet, and we all see the same tree and the same ocean and the same people and the same civilization on the planet. It's a massive multiplayer game, and we agree, and our computer, our subconscious mind, has logged in to the game. And it's then now you're in the world of Warcraft and you're not in the world of Skyrim, right? Different universe. The subconscious tunes into the universe. So all of us, we're tuned into our universe, and the other beings you see here, if they're real beings and not NPCs, then they have tuned in and logged into the same game you're playing. And you're playing with them, and you can communicate with them. So let's just imagine that's how it works. And off this planet, this big game is going on. So there's really no good guys and bad guys, reptilian regressives versus human progressive type beings. It's not really. That's the games we play when we enter into the physical universe experience from some other realm, where there is no good, bad, right, or wrong, pain, pleasure. There's no dichotomies. There's no polarity. There's no duality. Okay. But beings with superpowers will come into the game and agree to certain things as far as ability, personality, character, all this. Okay, so as we play this game, beings like you, we're talking about the superheroes that are going to come and help save Earth, right? So as we're playing around in the physical universe, this, that, and the other thing, through thousands or millions of years of play, and we go into one body, another body, another body, or we get into a really long living body, and we keep our continuity of memory, so we have a continuity of story. But anytime we want, we can pop out and we can go into another universe, we can move on the time It's not really moving on a time track. It's manifesting a time tuning into it. It gets deep, right? So anyway, as we're playing around, we get involved in the long ago, the reptilian regressives versus the Galactic Federation of Planets, big giant war in heaven thing. So you and I, super beings, superheroes, see this shit going down. You go, what the hell? So we pick a side. Somebody picked the side, the reptilian side. You and I, I'd say we've picked the, we're playing good, bad, right, wrong, good versus evil and all this shit. So we're good guys. And so as we see the game playing out, you and I, we see what the reptilians have done. We see that the Galactic Federation, as a wholesome, good organization to begin with, protecting the 500,000 planets, we see that they captured and won the big war, or at least in this sector, they captured and mind-controlled the reptilian regressives that were in control and dominating the local human population on planet Earth way back when. We just wrapped them in a fuzzball of dumbed down stupid. And all better. But you and I, we're out here going, whoa, 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 whoa. That was back then. What about now? Those poor fucking slob humans, the good guys, the decent beings, they're still being controlled and dominated and brutalized and tortured, mass murdered, mind controlled, upside down and fucking backwards by the local in control reptilians. And we're like going, Jesus, dude, can't you see that they are, these guys that are controlling this population are being protected by their politician buddies? Just like in this world right here, in the physical universe, planet Earth, United States of America, or pick a fucking country, England or Germany or anywhere, politicians everywhere that write the laws and puke out the bullshit are protecting criminals everywhere. And they are in on the drug trade and the adrenochrome and the torture and the drug trade and the guns and all this shit. This is an operation by the governing bodies. And they are protecting the local criminals on the street, pushing the money, the child trafficking, and the adrenochrome or the fucking drugs, right? The politicians and the governing bodies are protecting these motherfuckers, while as a group, working in the shadows, all this evil, satanic bullshit, casting spells and rituals and blood sacrifice shit, all kinds of creepy shit, they're all doing this behind the scenes in positions of power and governance. Okay? They're super rich and they're powerful and they're elite. And that's what they're doing on planet Earth. And they're just fucking the shit out of the fucking human population, the good guys. And the good guys off planet, human, nice, decent people, we have relatives. We're off planet. We have relatives, friends, loved ones, Lyrans from long ago, and even new people who have incarnated on Earth for whatever reason, however that happened. But we have, and man, they're getting fucking beat up. Now, these regressive reptilian types and evil fuckers, psychopaths that are controlling the planet, they're getting back up and support and help and commerce and interaction. They're shipping people off the planet and adrenochrome. They're just using the population as a fucking resource and a playground for sex and all kinds of weird shit. So, hey, yeah, they got their buddies off planet. It's like the mafia running a fucking sex ring. And they're calling, it's like fucking Epstein on his little fucking island, bringing all the politicians off his island, off planet Earth. Come on over, have a lot of fun. Pay me, and I'll probably fucking blackmail you if I can get away with it. But come on over, have fun, and go away, and I'm the, you know, the bad guy gets enriched. That's what they're doing on planet Earth. Those that are in control are doing that. And so those off planet are coming in and having a party, having a good time, and brutalizing the human population. All behind the scenes. Most, then it's all covered up and secret, and they own the fucking media, social platforms, they own it all. And so nobody gets to know general population. We have to really look for what's going on. What's going on? You're getting fucked. That's what's going on. And so they have the latest and greatest scenario that they had to get our agreement on. And even though things, the magic pill they would like you to take, see, there's another word, but I'm not going to use that word, am I? And we're not using that other word either. We're going to use, like, if there was a radiation issue and they had to take a pill, fabricated, there's no radiation issue. It's a fucking lie. But all the governments and every institution, everywhere, all kinds, every official outlet in the fucking world are saying, yeah, it's a radiation poisoning. There's no radiation poisoning. It's bullshit. There just isn't. And good doctors everywhere, specialists, go, there's no, that's not happening. It's like, it's the normal, there's no more radiation poisoning than you would normally get if you stand out in the fucking sun too long. Come on, this is normal. Bullshit, bullshit, story, it's just every fucking way, right? But that's the problem. And this isn't the real problem, you know, I'm not talking about the real problem. The real problem. But anyway, this is problem, and they get the population to react, problem react, reaction solution, right? So the population has to react predictably, of course. And save us, help us, we need, oh, that's okay. We have a magic pill. Just take this anti-radiation pill. Remember, this is a Doctor Who or a Netflix miniseries story. All right, keep that fucking clear, YouTube. All right? That's what this is. I'm telling a fucking idea for a miniseries on Netflix. Instead of Guardians of the Galaxy, right? And all these super... I'm still working on the superhero part, okay? All right. So, problem, reaction, solution, right? They come up with a bullshit story that is the problem. The people, every being on the planet, is start hearing this fucking bullshit lie-ass story, but they're imagining it. They're thinking it. And that will manifest it, at least from their perspective, and it's their reality. That this is a real problem. It's not a real problem. But they think it is. They bought the story. They agreed to it. It becomes their reality. It doesn't matter if it's, you know, it actually happens to them or not. And it's not gonna, because it's a fabrication. Okay? But they believe the story. And now they hear, that's okay, we have a solution. We have a magic pill. You just take this pill and it'll handle any kind of radiation issue you might have. This is a story. This isn't real. Okay, right? Here, take the pill. And so now they're dishing out, and they say, oh, well, the pill is still under research, and it's not, they're making it known. If they, full disclosure, it hasn't been approved yet. The pill hasn't been approved, but here. It's okay. Everybody's fine. So, they're giving away free pills because the dark side in this imaginary storyline, you know how Thanos in the Marvel comic universe, he wanted to get rid of half the population of Earth? It's kind of like that, but with the pill. So instead of him getting a magic stone on his fucking wrist thing, all the stones, he's dishing out pills. And I have to talk cryptic and bullshit. You know why. It's kind of like, you know, take the red pill or the blue pill. If you take the fucking blue pill, idiot, you think you're going to be safe from the radiation poisoning and radiation sickness. And in fact, that like they have the same plan of cut the population in half as Thanos did. Any evil, the evil of in any good fucking story wants to decimate half the fucking population. Well, same shit, new story, right? Okay. So people are starting to take the pill. And the trick on, in this Doctor Who story, is that the pill, they want everybody to take the pill. And they don't want anybody catching on that the pill's bad for you. So they do, one of the things they do is they give placebo pills to a lot of people. And so those people say, hey, I got the pill. The pill to protect me from radiation stuff. I'm good. See, no side effects here. And their friends and family go, oh, okay. The bad boys have to get our agreement to do the stupid thing. So stupid people or uneducated people, uninformed people, programmed people, people that just don't get it, mind-controlled people, manipulated people, are seeing their friends took the pill and there's no side effects. So they'll take the pill because they want to be protected too from the problem that isn't really a problem. It's a lie, bullshit story. But all their friends, but everybody's believing it, right? So, meantime, those that get it go, Jesus Christ, haven't you seen enough fucking science fiction movies yet? Aren't you predicting this fucking storyline yet? They're giving people placebos just to get more people to agree to take the pill. They've got a lot of time. They've got thousands of years to pull off their bullshit. Because these are the reptilians that live a long time anyway, probably 3,000 years at least. And then their you know, their prodigies or their or their descendants will take over. This is a big fucking, they live for this shit. Control and domination of planets and sentient beings throughout the galaxy and the universe. They ain't giving up. So anyway, here they are on the in our fucking Doctor Who universe. And Doctor Who, he can time fucking travel. So I know a time traveler. And So the time travelers are working it and going back and forth trying to see what the fuck, right? And you and I, we're time travelers too. Because a time traveler, there's technical time travel and there's sentient consciousness time travel. And the consciousness stuff is you shift in consciousness and retune into a reality. And you're not going anywhere. You're just winkless. It's like you have a 3D virtual reality holograph of, and we call it now. And it's like instead of a dial going and switching 2021, the year 2021, go to the year 1650. The year 1650 pops up all around you. You didn't time travel. You brought that time into focus for yourself. And the super conscious superhero that you are, you can fucking do this. So we can do it without machinery, without technology. But technology in this universe is so sophisticated that it can emulate or simulate the phenomena, assist people who need the mechanical assist. There's, you know, there's telepathy, and then there's the using the hardware and the software to assist your ability to read thoughts or something, shit, some shit like that. So, I'm gonna have to wrap this up. I gotta take off in a few minutes. So, how do you like my story so far? Would this make a great science fiction movie or a Netflix miniseries or something? Or maybe a whole fucking season? So, okay. So, they want us to take... They want the population of planet... Heart. We'll call the planet... Instead of Earth, this is all playing out on planet Heart. And, So, half the population has taken the fucking pill for a bullshit non-existent radiation poisoning. Okay, so the thing is, this pill is going to kill the population in about 2 years. And you kind of need a second pill later. So the reptilians, they want everybody, and those in control of Planet Heart, they want everybody to take the pill. So they got to get everybody's agreement, and so they're dishing out these pills. There's fake pills. There's nothing wrong with the pill, so there's not going to be any side effects, to get more people to agree to take the pill, and so the more and more people are supposed to take the pill. Okay. And if they can get over half the population to take the pill, they can wipe out half the population, just like Thanos, and then they can start. The reason they would want to do that is less, half as many beings, sentient conscious beings, so that's half as many people to manipulate and control. But another thing has to do with, like in the movie, The Falcon and the Winter Soldier in the Marvel comic universe, half the population fucking disappeared. But the half the population came back. And now there was an issue, a problem. Where do you put all these people after they were gone for 5 years? How do you reorganize the world with this powerful change? Well, the solution in the movie, I was just watching it last night, solution is one world, one people. Mm-hmm. They're pushing that fucking storyline. They want to implant in the consciousness of people, just like you and me watching that fucking Marvel Comic Universe fucking series. They want to impress upon our minds, our subconscious mind, these possibilities of one world, one people. And that's exactly what they would do if they could get away with it right now. The super rich power elite would love to have a one world, one people thing. And they could put in more control quicker, better, faster if they had a one world government. So they've been pushing that one forever. So anyway, there's a lot of dynamics involved in this whole thing. So as good guys, I want to talk about some other details, but other phenomena that's going on, but I can't because I'm running out of time. So, us superheroes from off the planet, outside the physical universe, come into play in the physical universe, just do this and that, and then we get more involved and kind of focus in on this galactic war and how they trapped the planet, and now they got the controllers on the planet, and they got their corrupt politicians and galactic fucking governance, and these guys are helping these guys, protecting these guys, while these guys are having a fucking ball and feeding humans and adrenochrome and just all kinds of resources and letting people come in and play with the humans and just fucking torture and all kinds of creepy shit. It's like they got a good sweet fucking deal, and it's all behind the scenes and it's all in the shadows. And while these politicians are saying no, the people that would really like to help the people on Earth are being told, stay away, you can't go in there, you can't interfere. Well, no shit, it's your sweet fucking playground and your money-making fucking deal. That's why people, good loving beings from outside the Earth mind control field, can't go in, can't help. That's the real reason, as I see it. Great story, huh? Yeah, great series. So you have some rebels, so to speak, breaking away from the Galactic Federation so that they are not under the control of the Galactic Federation. So we've got some groups of planets who have actually some very powerful military. So they were some of the best, most powerful military of the Galactic Federation. They said, fuck you, we're not working with you. You can't use our fucking armadas for your fucking purposes anymore. Oh, one of the purposes, by the way, was the Galactic Federation wanted one of the groups of good, loving human beings off planet Earth. They wanted them to use their powerful military to militarily protect this one planet or this one star system, Aldebaran. And why? I'll tell you why. This is again, this is kind of a spoiler alert, but the real reason, they tell everybody it's a different reason, but the real reason is when you get too close to Aldebaran, your psychic abilities start waking up. So something magic. It's like in the movie with Thanos, you get all the fucking stones, infinity stones, or whatever they're called, and you start getting your superpowers. Well, you get close, you hang out around Aldebaran for a while, and you'll get your fucking superpowers. Well, these regressives that are pretending to be progressive good guys in the Galactic Federation, and they're fucking agents, and you got the reptilians over here. The reptilians, the bad guys, off planet, are still trying to work it and fucking take control over the whole goddamn thing. They didn't take a walk and go away and say, okay, we're not going to play anymore. No, they're still working it. They're just doing very sneaky, subtle. So they come over here, and they tell their boys over here, hey, boys, this planet, or not this planet. Well, yeah, you can get on the planet, too. It'll probably affect things. But if you get too close to that Aldebaran, it'll turn on their psychic powers. And we don't want the good guys getting their psychic powers because they're going to beat our ass with those fucking psychic powers. So go over there and protect that planet. Tell them some bullshit story about why you want to protect the planet and protect the system, the star and all that shit. But we know the real fucking reason. We don't want any of the good guys getting too close to that fucking star and start turning on their superpowers. They might see right through our bullshit. And, you know, not good for our side. So there's that going on. So meantime, people like you and me, beings, powerful beings, I have to talk fast because I got to go in 5 fucking minutes. God damn it. So we're super beings, right? Okay, so we've got to get boots on the ground on the planet Earth, or heart, depending on, we don't real and imaginary worlds here, but we got to get our boots on the ground and start imagining some new shit, positive shit. How do we turn this fucking thing around? Because if we just thinking, hey, we're fucked, we're doomed, that's just playing into and reinforcing the negative reality that is to be manifested, that the dark side wants manifested for Earth. And we don't want to do that. We want to come up with a new fucking imaginary story. Imagine it. Work on the manifestation. Learn your manifestation techniques, how that really works, so that you can manifest a better reality for yourself and your friends and loved ones. So we got to come down, boots on the ground. Some fucking stupid ass rule, apparently, we have to block out our memory, or we choose to. It's just, what? Anyway, we imagine we're getting it back. We're getting back our memory, our abilities. We're seeing the bigger picture. We get on the fucking ground here, and we start telling fucking stories. We start thinking new things, positive things, about how no matter what else plays out with the taking the little pill to protect yourself from radiation, whatever else happens, there's too many people are waking up to what's really going on. People are waking up to what's going on, who's doing what to who and why, and they're saying no to the magic pill, the pill that's supposed to fix it all, that really is going to devastate the entire population. And so enough people have woken up, and we've been able to change with feet on the ground, with movement, with action, with protest, with speaking up, with changing platforms. There's a great odyssey.com. You can share all your videos and you can talk about anything you fucking want. Okay? And they will automatically pull, if you've got 1,000 videos on your YouTube channel, they will pull them over. It'll take only about 4 days and you're up and running. You've got all your videos, all the titles, all the tags, everything's right there on your new. There's ways, and there are people in the world right now making these profound changes and telling other people about what's really in the magic pill. that devastating, not good for you magic pill. They're telling people what it is. And you can figure out new clever ways to share with your friends and loved ones what's in the magic fucking pill. Just come up. There are ways. It's just communication techniques to help open the door. People who have bought the bullshit, the lies, the deception coming from authority and government and all this stuff, you can change their mind with different techniques and strategies. So do that, and we are powerful superhero magic creators, and we can create the new reality for people of heart. Our imaginary planet in our Netflix series of all of this fucking story played out. And we'll see just how close it is, how close our little story is to the reality of things. Okay? Alrighty. I would love to have fleshed this out a little bit longer and better for you, but I have to take off. And I will talk to you later. Share your thoughts about this. It's, you know, you can call it just a story, an outline, a treaty, treaties for a possible story that could take place in like a Doctor Who universe or a Marvel comic universe. Or it could even be a computer game, couldn't it? So yeah. Comments are welcome, and I will talk to you later, okay? Bye, my man.